Hello everyone, today you join me in Trinity College, Cambridge, with my guest today. This is Hugh Hunt, who will introduce himself.
Yes, I'm Hugh. I'm a fellow of Trinity College. I'm a lecturer in the engineering department.
And we're here today in Hugh's office, which is a lot like my office, only much swankier. So it's nothing like my office in that case.
Apart from there's lots of toys.
Apart from having lots of toys, which is what we have in common. And this is one of Hugh's toys, which is he's invited me over to see today. And this is one of those old mechanical calculators that they used to use in the early part of the 20th century. And what is this called then? What's this name?
It's called the original Odhner.
Odhner?
Well, I don't know.
We're not sure. And can you tell me the history of this machine?
Well, these things date back to, I think, the late 1800s, when a Russian inventor came up with this mechanical adding machine.
Right.
And really just worked out that multiplication is just glorified adding. And division is glorified subtraction. And this was in the engineering department of, of Cambridge University. Mm-hmm. And it was probably in use for real in the 1930s, 1940s, 1950s. But then when, of course, electrical computing machines came in, then in the 70s and 80s, and of course these things were just museum pieces. And I happen to have one.
And you happen to have one as well. Well, we're not saying that you're a museum piece, but we are going to use this mechanical calculator today to do one of the more challenging operations, which is to find the square root of a number. But first of all, before we show you that, we're going to show you some of the more basic operations. Okay, so show me something simple. Show me how to add on this machine. So how would you add on a mechanical calculator like this?
Well, let's suppose I've got a number like 4,698. Mm-hmm. So I key up 4,698 onto here. And what I can do is just to crank this handle around once. And that's added 4,698 onto what was there before, which was zero. If I crank the handle around again,
You've added it on twice.
Three times, four times. And it's actually counting how many times I've added it on over here. So five times, six times. Well, this is neat, because then I get to 10 times. If I've added this number to itself 10 times, well, I've just multiplied it by 10.
So this shows that repeated addition is just another way to multiply. Mm. And that's all we're doing. So this is just repeated addition.
It is.
And how would we subtract?
Well, that's easy. I just crank the handle backwards.
I do like that. That's really nice.
So I've cranked the handle backwards 10 times, and I'm back to zero.
So if you want to subtract, you just turn the crank the opposite direction.
Yeah,
that's really easy. How would I divide a number?
Now, suppose I wanted to divide 4698 mm-hmm. by, say, 162.
Okay.
Well, what I'll do is I'll put that into this register here.
Right.
And now I'm going to see how many times do I need to subtract 162.
Right. Now, so if we're dividing by 162, we're just counting how many times we subtract it.
Now, I could just put 162 into here and then set my counter to count backwards for me. And I could just do this, 1, 2, 3, 4. And keep on going. I'm watching the number getting smaller and smaller and smaller until eventually, there we are. It's zero.
And so the answer is?
29.
29. So we got 29 on the counter here on the left-hand side. So if multiplication is just repeated addition, then I'm guessing division is just repeated subtraction. Okay, so now we're going to work out the square root of a number, which is going to be a much more difficult thing to do. And there's a nice little, surprising really, little mathematical fact that you can do to work out the square root of
a number. That's absolutely right. And it's really nice. If I take the square root of something like 4, then that's 1 add 3.
That is, yes.
If I take the square root of 9, that's 1 add 3 add 5. Mm-hmm. Square root of 16 is 1 add 3 add 5 add 7.
So you're just adding up the odd numbers.
So if I've got 25 squares here, mm-hmm. but what I can do is I can work out that 25 is the square root of 5.
Yes.
By subtracting 1, then 3, then 5, then 7, then 9. 5 operations, 5 must be the square root of 25.
So to work out the square root of a number, you just subtract odd integers, and the number of times you have to subtract is the answer.
And I can do that on this machine. So for instance, I can put 25 into here, whiz that into the register there, okay. And now I go into subtracting mode. And so the first thing I'll do is I'll subtract off 1.
Okay.
And I get 24. And I'll subtract off 3. And I'll subtract off 5. And I'll subtract off 7. And then I'll subtract off 9. And I've got nothing left. And how many times did I do it?
5.
So 25 is a reasonably easy number. Let's suppose I've got a number like 4489.
Okay, 4489, that's a big number.
Well, I happen to know that that's 67 squared.
Okay.
But what I'm interested to know is whether I can use some neat property of 6 and neat property of 7 to get 4489. And what we discover is that 4489 is 60 squared plus 7 squared.
Okay.
Plus 2 lots of 60 times 7.
Ah.
Now, if I'm really careful, I can subtract off the 60 squared bit, and I can subtract off the 7 squared bit. If I can keep track of the 2 lots of 60 times 7, then I've got my square root of 4489.
So we know how to find the square root of 60 squared. We've worked that out. We know how to find the square root of 7 squared. And we just have to keep track of the rest of it. How would I do this if I wanted to work out something like the square root of 2?
Well, 67 was only 2 significant figures.
Mm-hmm.
So square root of 4489, we didn't have to do that many operations to get our answer of 67. Square root of 2 is 1.414, lots of decimal places, lots of significant figures. So if I want to get square root of 2, I have to work quite a lot harder. But let's just do it. The nice thing is the algorithm, the procedure of looking after all those 20s and 200s is all done by the machine. So I'm going to set up my 2 up here. Now I'm putting it way up here because I need space to look after my decimal places. I need all this space to look after my decimal places. So now I've put the 2 into this register. Now I'm going to do all my subtractions. Now that seems like black magic, and actually that's what mathematics so often looks like. And the beauty of it is that if you can decipher that black magic, suddenly it's just, hey, it's obvious. And it's just fantastic that this machine, it's a way of keeping track of things that if you had to do it by hand, you would make mistakes. So 1.414215.
35. So this is going to be our square root. And you're gonna check that, are you?
1.414216. I've managed to calculate square root of 2 to 8 significant figures on a machine that really all it can do is to add and subtract.